In my grant writing classes, I talk a lot about building a really strong project team. But a lot of times, you also need your own team just to deliver on a project, especially if it's a complex grant. So recently, I was proposing to the Alaska Railroad. I think we should, let's, they wanted to go after a build grant through the Department of Transportation. Those were formerly Tiger Grants. They're insanely competitive and super. It's not that they're super difficult, but boy, they require a lot of information and they have a very particular benefit cost analysis process. And I am not equipped to do a benefit cost analysis. When you outsource that to an engineering firm, it's really expensive. It can be anywhere from $12,000 to $20,000. And so I realized, and I've done a Tiger Grant, I've done a variety of transportation projects, but I wouldn't say it's been, I don't have a ton of experience in that arena. And so I felt that if I want to be really darn confident that this proposal is successful, I need someone to work with, another grant writer that has this expertise. So I spent a ton of time trying to figure out who were the successful grant writers, but or who were the grant writers behind last year's successful grants. And that's a surprisingly challenging thing to get an answer on sometimes because grant writers are sort of behind the scenes, they're out of the way. So it took a little bit of digging. But I did find one person, Ron Flavin. He's done a variety, he has an insane resume. The guy has worked on a ton of cool projects. And he did Nenana, Alaska's successful build grant last year. So I reached out to him, and theoretically, he could have just taken the proposal and responded himself and probably got it without even needing me to be there. So you could say I approached the competition and asked them to be on my team, but frankly, that's what needed to happen so that I am really sure we are bringing the best team possible to getting this grant because it's competitive and we need to do a really good job. We don't get second and third chances. This program just gets more competitive. So yeah, I reached out to Ron. He was totally game. We just had our kickoff yesterday. It's so nice to have someone else on board that's an outstanding writer. He's taking on writing the first version of our narrative. He's already put together the skeleton and template. I'll get it back. I can start filling in the gaps and working in person with the team members at the railroad. And it's just kind of an incredible and beautiful process. So I also have another gal on the team, Jackie Braden, and she has been coming to the meetings and she's my note taker. I mean, she's capturing so much information that I can't run a meeting and also write down and listen. You just can't do it all. So if you don't have a second person, you can always just record, asking for permission, of course. But it's really nice when you can just have someone capture notes, capture action items, and then bam, when you're done with that meeting, be able to send those out. So I think that's all I really wanted to share about this. I just wanted to emphasize, be creative and look for the very best team you can possibly have on any given project, sort of a la carte bringing them in wherever they exist. Because with a really dynamite team, the odds are in your favor to succeed. And the more proposals that are successful, the happier you are, and the happier your organization is, and the communities that you serve. So if you have any questions specifically about teaming, anything at all as it relates to grant writing, drop it in the comments and I'll see if I can't get them answered for you.